I'm going to talk to you about the relationship between GNOME and ownCloud, how we're collaborating, what we do already, and how we can do even better in the future, what more we can collaborate on.
So, yeah, I'm very happy to be back at Gladek. I made GNOME from running this document usability in free software. It was my thesis back in 2011. Back in 2010, I was at my first Gladek. It's now my fifth, I think. I also like to call it Gladek, the GNOME users and developers and designers European conference. So, yeah. I'm happy that this year also ownCloud, the company ownCloud Inc., is sponsoring GNOME, it's supporting the center. So that I think is quite cool. And yeah, maybe you remember if you were in Brno 2013, I also gave a talk on the collaboration between GNOME and ownCloud. And it's quite funny when I looked at the picture back again, I saw some quite funny reactions. So yeah. Facepalming, wondering what the hell this is about. Jakob's very interested. But yeah, it was quite a cool conference, and we got a lot done there. So I hope this is a good follow up, and we can push it forward even more. So first of all, can I have a show of hands who knows ownCloud? Yeah, who doesn't know ownCloud? Okay, like no one? Okay. Who uses ownCloud regularly? Cool, awesome. So yeah, I guess I can spare that then. I mean, yeah, it's like a sync solution, it syncs all your stuff, has a server component, has apps. Yeah, this is the web interface. Maybe you don't know the latest version, like we have a new sidebar, we have thumbnails, yeah, we improve the design always, and that was just released basically. And yeah, that's version 8.1. And if you don't know yet, or wherever you use it, you know, there's cloud.gnome.org. And previously, or in 2013, I said you need to ask Andrea about getting an account. Now he told me that he connected it to the GNOME LDAP, and so you can log in with your GNOME account, and you get 1 GB of free space. And if you want more, you can just ask him. So yeah, he nods, so just do that if you want to use that. And yeah, you can also then, because on the client we're working on a new version, which will be released soon, you can have multiple accounts. So you can connect your existing ownCloud account and your cloud.gnome.org account to sync to your desktop. On the mobile clients, Android and iOS, that's already possible. Yeah, so. Let's see, the desktop integration, what do we have right now? What do we have today? What did we achieve 2013 already and so far? I like to think of it as the lanyard from GNOME. Like it always seems it's a bit complicated. There's a whole bunch of stuff in between that you need to, or that you can remove. So I like to remove these things in between, make it simpler. So let's see how we did that. For now, it's the GNOME online account. So yeah, thanks Debarshi and others for working on that. We currently have, as you see, we have a calendar, contacts, documents, and files. So the basic core apps are synced already. You can add multiple accounts, and yeah, it's pretty simple to set up. And that's already like the mass of apps synced. The one thing is, of course, files are a mount, they're not synced, but for that you can use the ownCloud desktop client. And yeah, we want to integrate that even more into Nautilus in the future, but I'll also come to that. For example, in this way, where we have in the web interface a sidebar with all files, for example, then favorite files, and files shared with you, you shared with others, stuff you share by link, and external storages. So you can mount, like, I don't know, Dropbox, Amazon S3, other FTPs, other own clouds, and that is filtered. Now, you can have that in the web interface, like favorites and files shared with you. And also, if you use the sync client, it will place badges on the files, which are, of course, which are synced, but also which are shared. So when you look through Nautilus, you see which files are shared. But you can't really filter. So I was thinking also, already talking to Carlos, about integrating that more into Nautilus, like having a view, maybe for all providers, for all GNOME online account providers, to have like a favorites view, or to have it in general in GNOME, which I hear is also the plan, and also to have a view of shared files, which makes it way easier to find, to unshare, to share the link again, and stuff like that, all which makes it easier for desktop and cloud integration. Now, yeah, those are like the baselines. That's basically the stuff that we achieved so far. So let's see what we can still work on, or what we're working on. One issue, topic that we're working on is music syncing. We have a music app. Actually, I brought the developer of the music app with me. Morris, he's sitting there. He's also a core developer of ownCloud, and we have for ownCloud Music specifically, we expose an API called Ampachi, which can be used by any music app. It's also used by other solutions like Subsonic, for example, and it's an open source API for music syncing and streaming. So we've been talking to Vadim about integrating that, and we'll hope we'll get some steam behind that. Another thing is the bookmark sync. So we also have a bookmarks app, and it would be cool to have Epiphany or GNOME Web sync the bookmarks with ownCloud, of course, so that you can have them on all your devices if you have several different laptops, different desktop devices and stuff. And that would be quite cool. I actually didn't talk to anyone about that at this conf yet, so if you feel like, I should talk to you, cool, great, we'll talk later. Another one is open source maps apps in general. So I already talked to Matthias and to Jonas, what I basically think would be cool is to have syncing of favorites, for example, of recent searches, of routes, of stuff, all the things Google Maps basically does, and you don't even, maybe not even realize that they sync it, or that it's good to sync stuff from maps, like the favorites, like, I don't know, restaurants you like to go to, stuff you save. We need like an open source solution to sync all that stuff, to save all that stuff. So in a similar way that Google knows where you're at home, where you work, we can then do some awesome stuff with it, with mobile apps. You can let your imagination flow on that one. So that would be really cool to get a sync on that. The ownCloud Maps app is very basic at this point. It has a maps view, and like you can search stuff. So we also need to work on it. To have a basic content flow going would be really cool. Another thing is newsreader. So it's kind of funny. I talked to Vadim about it as well, because he wants to work on it. There seems to be no shortage of newsreaders. Like music is a more rare app, or there are fewer music apps, but newsreaders all over the place. Like there's, I think, three apps on Firefox OS which connect to the ownCloud newsreader. So yeah, there you go. There's no file sync for Firefox OS, but yeah, three newsreaders. Anyway, we have an API which can be implemented, and it's already implemented also by an Android app, by an iOS app. They all do offline sync of your feed, so you can read them when you're offline, and you can read the whole feed, downloads images, it even downloads podcasts, I think, and videos, like if you subscribe to a YouTube channel or something like that. So that, I think, is quite cool. And it's basically a Google Reader full replacement, web interface, mobile apps and stuff. So yeah, what's missing is basically a really cool desktop app. Then I'm also really excited about that there is like a bunch of bug reports coming in collaborating on fixing these small things which don't work, or bigger things which are planned for GNOME and ownCloud collaboration. But you also see the top issue there as BGBan, that's GNOME Nodes. So you can already, if you install BGBan, the app, it's a Nodes app if you don't know it. if you know it and don't know you can use ownCloud with it, you can. So you can just go through the settings and choose the default notebook, and then your notes will just be synced. It's basically just plain text notes, which are saved in the notes subfolder in your ownCloud, and yeah, there's also a web app for that, there's also mobile apps for that. So that, I think, is pretty cool. I use that all the time. Then, beyond apps, I think we have, especially with desktop integration, we have the opportunity, or we need to also sync other things except app content. For example, all the settings, like your background image. Like, you don't want to set your background image again all the time when you set up a new computer, when you have a different computer. Maybe you want a different image there, but then you probably would be able to set it with like some profiles or so. But if you want the same image, and if you change it, and if you want to propagate it across your machines, you should be able to do that. Similarly, Wi-Fi information. Wi-Fi is, you connect it to, it's always a pain when you have a new laptop or you have a separate device and you want to connect to a new Wi-Fi. Google syncs the Wi-Fi, it's like with your Android phone, with your Chromebook or whatever, and that we should be able to do too. Same for printers, for example. Like, I don't really care that much about printers, but when I need one or when I want to print something, then it should be configured like the way I left it. Like, I don't know, printing draft or grayscale or whatever I want to do with it, like photos. And so syncing these settings for that is also really important, I think. And it's not that big of a deal, or it's not a big chunk of data like syncing a video or syncing music. So that's something we could quite easily do, I guess. And then another thing, very interesting point, is like syncing the profile as well. So currently, for example, in GNOME, you have the account name, and it's only really local. Right? Similarly, for ownCloud, you set the picture and you set the name, and it's on your ownCloud. Like, your other users see the image and stuff when you share it with them, share something with them. But we could connect that. Like, we could connect these profiles, and you could even, for example, sign in to your ownCloud with your GNOME to your laptop with your ownCloud account, for example. It could just be like the same password, for example, because it's just like, why have a different password from that? So there's also a discussion about that, and something also I talked to Carlos about is that we can enable GNOME users to use their ownCloud account to log in, for example, and sync the basic settings like printers and stuff. So, I mean, that's all up in the air, and that's all like just discussion material, right? That's all something we can do and interesting things. And I hope we can talk like today and the next days to what if that is realistic to do, and what if that would be cool or doable. Yeah. So let's see about further collaboration. Like, what can we do? What can we do in the future? What cool stuff is there that we have from ownCloud? And what other things we can collaborate on? For example, we have, as I said, we have different apps. We have also, an app store, basically. Everyone can write their own app. The ownCloud web server is written in PHP, so you can deploy it anywhere, almost. And there's, as I said, the news app. It's pretty well designed. It looks nice. Then there's a tasks app, so we also have tasks sync. I'm not aware of any GNOME tasks app. Is there any?
Yes.
Yeah?
Now there is.
Okay.
Yeah, hopefully
we'll
have a stable release for
3.18. Great, okay. So 3.18 tasks app. So yeah, we can also sync that with GNOME online accounts, like just with the CalDev sync backend, I guess. Already does. Great. That's awesome. Okay. Nothing to be done here. I'm gonna leave. So there's a bunch of more apps that you see: multimedia, productivity, game tools, games tools, and other stuff. There's also we have this new thing called experimental applications. You see that on the bottom. That's like a thing you can enable as an admin if you want to try out basically everything which comes into the app store. So we have like a three-tier process. Like, we have official apps, which are like developed by kind of a core team, and which are like security review, design review, or I worked on them for the design. And then we have like apps by the community, which are reviewed and approved, so they get this yellow seal of approval. And then there's experimental applications, which are like all the rest. Everything you upload on the App Store is experimental, and you can opt in the web interface to basically access them or to see them. So you can also enable them and try them out. So yeah, we wanted to, or we enabled that with the latest release to make it possible for people to try out the new cool apps if they dare to. So pay attention to your data then, because there's no guarantee for experimental applications, but we think it's very cool to showcase new stuff, like, I don't know, staging development and latest stuff for people who don't want to clone from Git. For example, another app, which is, it's not experimental, it's pretty stable, is the Documents app. So there's a whole bunch going on here. There's comments, it's collaboration, you have two different people collaborating on a document, you have what you see is what you get editing. It's basically like, it uses OLT documents, so it syncs with your own cloud, it just edits OLT documents from inside your own cloud, and it's kind of like similar to Google Docs or Etherpad, but more like Google Docs, I guess, with collaboration and proper what you see is what you get editing. So yeah, if you don't know it yet, that's ownCloud Documents. It's been around since some time, and it's really cool for collaboration. Another thing is the Notes app, what I was mentioning earlier, the plain text Notes app. It's much simpler than the Documents app, but what just landed by an awesome contributor is inline markdown support. So you probably know of these two pane markdown editors. Like on the left you see the source code, on the right you see the rendered stuff, like LaTeX editors, for example. And I think those are like a bit subpar with editing concerns. So I think this is really cool to have, like, if you know markdown, to have the markup and the visualization at the same time. So if you, for example, remove the hash, then it isn't marked up as a head anymore. Or if you use the asterisks, you can make a list and stuff. So that I think is really cool. And the best thing is, it's not in your way when you don't know markdown, it's just plain text. But if you know markdown, you can use it and it's gonna show up pretty nicely. So yeah, that's the online Notes app. Then another thing we've been working on is ownCloud Mail. So last time, 2013, I just linked to the repository and it was like, something we are kind of working on and it might be stable and stuff. So we've been working a lot more on that. So you already see on the left, this is even some bit older screenshot of the current 0.1. We're working on a 0.2, like it's going to be released in, like, hopefully the next days. Should have been released 2 weeks ago, but as you know, it's always a bit finicky. But as you see already, there's multiple account support. So it's my personal account, my company account. We now have unified inbox already in the latest master. Then you simply have a list of the messages. You have the avatars are loaded from ownCloud contacts. So if you sync them with GNOME contacts, you have the same data, like the profile pictures. The same email addresses, like when you write a new message, it has this type ahead. So if I want to write an email to some of you, I just can just type the name and we'll suggest them. Just basic email stuff, right? One big thing it doesn't do yet is threading or conversations, but that's something planned for the next version. So yeah, it's approaching 0.2, but there's a lot of cool stuff. For example, also, for replies and new messages, you can attach files from the ownCloud Files app. So I think pretty cool to connect the ownCloud data and your mail more. And what we plan in the future is to have not attachments, but that you can directly, if you press attach or if you insert a link, you can basically directly insert the link into the email for a file that is on your own cloud. So for a company or for just some data you don't want to send around, but for example a document you want to collaborate on, you can simply send the link for others to view and not the actual document. So that's pretty cool privacy-wise, and also for collaboration, so that not everyone's sending around like, hey, this is the final version and this is final version 2 and that deal. So yeah, ownCloud Mail, that's like also up on our GitHub, github.com/ownCloud/mail if you want to try it out. Then another really cool thing, which is in since I think 2 versions, is federated sharing. So now that I'm in Gothenburg together with Morris, we shared a folder for our pictures. And so I created the folder on my ownCloud and shared it with Morris on his ownCloud. You see he has a different domain. So you can just type in the username at the ownCloud and it will share it to him, and he needs to accept it or reject it. And then he has like the shared folder just as if we were on the same ownCloud. And it syncs to both our devices, and yeah, it's just like normal collaboration. So I think that's pretty awesome. And yeah, if you ask me, or if you want to share something with me, you can ask me for my federation ID, and then we can share some stuff. So I think that's a really cool feature. It's the same for when you share a link with someone. Like I share a link to some photos with you, and you have an ownCloud yourself, and you want to have the photos in your ownCloud. You can you have this button on the top bar to add this to your ownCloud, and then you will be able to enter your domain, and then it will add the folder to your ownCloud. So yeah, we're working on making the flow even a bit simpler. Like maybe with the browser remembering the ownCloud and stuff like that. So yeah, that's all improvements we want to do still. And yeah, lastly, as I mentioned already before, the new desktop client has the multi-account support. So you see first my company account, then my personal account, and you have the possibility to sync as many accounts as you want. So I guess mostly it will be just 1 or 2, maybe 3, but yeah, you have like, you can potentially sync a bunch of accounts, and the rest is basically the same. I mean, we did some design improvements, simplified it a lot. We have selective sync, so you can choose to, for example, not sync your giant videos folder or music folder if you're on a small machine. So yeah, just basically standard sync stuff as well, I guess. But that's like, we're really getting to a pretty cool state. So if you already use ownCloud and don't know of these features, like that's what will be coming in the next version. So I'm pretty excited about multi-account support, and especially federated sharing. I mean, federated sharing is already there. Yeah, that's pretty much the thing. Like, I think we should talk more. Like, you can find us on github.com/ownCloud, that's where all our code lives. We have all the, like, most of the core apps there, like, mail is there, just under /mail, and we have the news app there, we have the notes app there, we have calendar, contacts there, yeah, the core, the client, everything. So if you want to look at the code or contribute, you're very welcome to. And then we have IRC channels, they're all on the Freenode network. So the ownCloud developer channel is just #ownCloud-dev. If you want to talk to the client developers, or if you want to get involved there, it's ownCloud-client-dev. And if you want to talk to designers, basically the same as the GNOME design channel, we have an ownCloud-design channel. Yeah. So, right. Another important thing is at the end of this month, so August 28th till September 3rd, is the second annual ownCloud Contributor Conference in Berlin, at the TU Berlin, at the Technical University. And I already talked to a few people and invited them. And yeah, if you want to come, like, join us. It's in Berlin, it's for free. And if you're nearby, just let us know, or just turn up. You can find more info at owncloud.org/conf. Yeah, so it would be cool to have some of you folks there. And yeah, that's all. Thank you for having me. Yeah, are there any questions, comments, anything?
Okay, so this is a bit of a tall question, so excuse me for that. But when are you going to move from Qt to GTK in the sync app?
That's a good question. I guess never, because we use Qt just for the cross-platform capabilities. So it's the same for OS X, for Windows, and for Linux. I talked to Carlos, though, about what I was mentioning earlier about closer integration. And he said, or he asked me if we can like somehow get rid of the Qt part and just use like the lower level stuff, like the connection to the ownCloud account and the OC sync, like the sync API to integrate it better into GNOME. So while with the core app, we're probably not gonna like switch to GTK, we're discussing about what to do to more tightly integrate it into GNOME. Yeah. So good question. It's not a troll question, it's a relevant one. Yeah.
So, most of the existing stuff on the client side, which uses files, are using WebDAV at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
But I see that you now have a few fancy things like favorites and sharing and things like that.
Yeah.
So, is there a new REST-based API that clients are supposed to use, or is it still WebDAV?
So maybe that's something that Morris can answer better. I think there's some extension to WebDAV, but I don't want to say anything wrong.
We planned an API based on WebDAV, but that's in discussion. So we have a separate WebDAV interface where you can list all your favorites and all your versions and refreshment and stuff like that. But currently, all the stuff is handled over our very own OCS API, ownCloud sync, yeah, something like that. That's an XML or JSON API, something like REST, but not RESTful. And it's mostly for fetching data, like favorites. And that's currently working, and that's how the client currently fetches all the additional data.
Yeah. But we're working on like standardizing that and rediscussing, so it's in the process basically right now. So I mean the client, for example, also gets that info from the server, like if a file is shared, to show the badges, for example, to show if a file was shared, and that can be used by other apps.
So for an application like say GNOME Documents, just an example,
mm-hmm.
like if I want to add a shared dialog to it,
mm-hmm.
or a favorites thing to it, should I wait for the WebDAV extensions to take shape? Should I start using the JSON XML basis? I'm just asking as a developer, like.
Yeah, but Morris can probably answer that better.
Yeah, you simply use the existing OCS API. We guarantee 3 years of support for all the external APIs. So once we announce that the created API, it is stable until 3 years after this announcement, so use the existing ones and you're on the safe side.
Yeah. And you're very welcome to like take part in the discussion and like what we want to standardize on, basically. So if you're interested in that. Any more questions? Comments? Yeah.
You were talking a bit about synchronizing things like the background and the user's profile, and thinking that ahead a bit evolutionary, I think this leads to some kind of universal backup solution which makes you able to just click one button and make it sync your whole system, and click one button on another machine and get basically a clone of that system. So we could actually think about using PackageKit or so to even try to synchronize the system configuration around the user or some things like that. The question is, do you have kind of a grand plan for that stuff, and how long does it take until we finally get the full system backup by our own cloud?
I mean, the question is like, what you think about that, right? What GNOME thinks about that. So, I mean, we we have the server, right? But like we're cross-platform, and I mean there could even be like cross-platform sync of backgrounds and stuff like that. But grand plan, not really. I mean it would be cool. What you say, like syncing all the settings around the user. Yeah, that's basically like what I want, what I would really like to see. So the question is like, who do we need to talk to? Like, are you the right person to talk to, for example?
I guess not.
Do you know who is?
Not right now.
Okay, because like if you know the right person to talk to about that, that would be really cool. Yeah.
So I think anybody from GNOME want the same thing and you can tell with. You just need to someone that start working on it. So
yeah, exactly. Yeah, same for us. We're both community driven projects, so yeah.
Yeah, so my question was, I saw those new things and are very cool. It refers me to the service that Google is doing with Android and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, are you commit to those ideas? I mean, those ideas are like stable and you are commit to maintain them. Do you have bigger plans for the future, like new ideas, like those, or?
What do you exactly mean? Like for example, unified sync, or?
Like the nodes or the collaborating edition of documents or something like that. It's like use themes, internal themes that are not public, or it's something that is public and you are commit to keep them?
Well, everything that we plan is essentially public. So all the discussions, like, I mean, currently, for example, we're working on a sidebar for files, which will have like details about it, which will have the sharing dialogue, which is currently another dialogue. And we're planning on having, for example, comments on the files, basically like a chronological view of what happened with the files, like who edited it and then who made a comment on it. So have like a timeline of the file, for example. That would be something that we're planning, and that's also opening in an issue discussion. We're basically doing all our stuff, all the feature planning and things on GitHub issues.
So people like GNOME can rely on those things already. Like we could implement some things to support them in the desktop.
Well, it's in the works. Like for example, comments. That's not even really started yet. So I mean, what I was thinking, for example, for the future is like next to the favorites and the shared stuff, which should be more of like a general thing, like across GNOME, across other providers. Something that would be interesting for ownCloud especially is like versions, for example, right? If you want to roll back to a past version, we have a versions app in ownCloud, which whenever you do a change, it saves a new version. And it also cleans up versions depending on like the date, like if you don't have enough storage anymore. So it might be interesting to have like some mechanism to access the versions from GNOME, rollback, something like that. Like basically like a time machine on a Wise X thread.
Okay.
If that's something like a point, for example, what you would mean.
Okay. And the last thing.
we can talk later.
Yeah.
Thanks. I actually also have a question in between. Who do I need to talk to about syncing mail settings? Like syncing mail accounts. I think we talked to someone last year or the year before, but I don't remember who it was. Maybe someone from Evolution or so. I don't know, like, is there also any plan like for something like GNOME mail or so that I'm not aware of? Just like tasks, for example? No? Okay, cool. Evolution data server maintenance. Thanks. Any more questions? Or comments or feedback?
I just wanted to say that I think it's a really nice effort on reaching out to GNOME from ownCloud. And
thanks.
I was wondering, this conference you are having in Berlin,
mm-hmm.
Is there going to be talks there as well? And would it make sense to have the equivalent, similar talk where we
to know which back.
Yeah. So actually,
collaborating started working.
Yeah, yeah, that would be really cool. I mean, that's why I'm also asking people to come. So we have 2 days, the weekend of August 29th and 30th, is that like Saturday and Sunday? We have talks. So we mostly have lightning talks. We have 2 keynotes. Then we also have workshops, like 1 hour workshops or 2 hour, like whatever you want to do. But we also like, I mean, I need to talk to Jos, our community manager, but we could even fit like a longer, like slightly longer talk than just a 5 minute lightning talk on GNOME collaboration. So yeah, if someone is interested in doing that, we also have travel funding, like we can support you with like 80% of hotel and travel. So yeah, that goes for everyone who is like really interested in collaborating. Yeah, and it would be really cool to have like a talk and even like a workshop, 1 hour, 2 hour workshop where we can sit down, like basically like a golf gear, and work more on the integration. Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Cool. Thanks. Any more questions? Any feedback? How do you like ownCloud? What do you hate about ownCloud?
The logo.
The logo? Oh, fuck. Sorry, I always feel that. It was not designed by me, let's say that much. But what else? Anything about the interface? Okay. Yeah? Like, you mean like a box that you like run at home, for example?
Yeah, like buy a box, it's pre-installed with ownCloud, I connect it to my router,
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we've been thinking about that and like people have been excited about that. You can run it on a Raspberry Pi, for example. It runs very well on like the E+, on the original one as well, I think, with a few modifications. There's a bunch of blog posts. I mean, we're not gonna like sell boxes because that's like going into the hardware business. That's quite like that's not what we do. Like the ownCloud company, just like a few words about what the company does. Maybe it just does enterprise support. So yeah, support, customization, stuff like that. And we're not hosting anything, which is a pain in the ass, of course, because you need to go down with you need to go up with the storage, down with the prices, and also hardware is not something that there are plans to go into. But anyone could do that.
Actually, some of the commercially available NAS boxes you can buy and actually ship with
right.
Apps.
Yeah. Right, the Synology, I think. Okay, yeah. The what? QNAP? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, there's some boxes in this. I think there's also a Docker image, so yeah, anyone can really like roll their own thing. It's not something like we're gonna centrally enforce or something. I mean, that would be kind of ridiculous as well. Yeah. Any more questions, feedback, comments? Do you like everything about ownCloud? Do you not hate anything about the interface and usability feedback? I'm here now, so you can talk to me. Okay. I guess we can also talk in private if you want to wrap up. Then, yeah, thanks again, and yeah, cheers for the Seal of Sweden. If you see the sticker around somewhere here, I found it quite cute. So, anyway, thanks.